Hello students, looking at current affairs for 9th April, the news items picked up from the Hindu newspaper are these 9. We look at them in detail. The first one, it will not be possible to lift the lockdown in one go, says Prime Minister Modi. So a video conference was held by the Prime Minister with parties, floor leaders in parliament, and it was said by him that it is not possible to lift the 21-day nationwide lockdown in one day as scheduled for April 14th. So he said, however, that he would consult the chief ministers before deciding the exit strategy. So even states have taken individual measures for further extension of the lockdown. Then next is focus shifts to contact tracing infrastructure. So Union Health Ministry has said that building hospital infrastructure, aggressive contact tracing and total enforcement of the lockdown with the help of people were the main focus now in the fight against COVID-19. In the last 24 hours, 32 COVID-19 deaths have been reported. So this is how states have been affected. And this also is showing an Indian Air Force aircraft ferrying medical equipment from Chennai to Odisha for setting up COVID-19 testing facilities there. Then next is Kerala experts for three-phase easing of curbs. So an expert committee headed by former Kerala Chief Minister K.M. Abraham has recommended a phased relaxation of the lockdown to contain COVID-19 in Kerala. So there are three phases in which relaxation are being recommended. So each relaxation, what will be the relaxations and what are the conditions for relaxations are suggested. These are just suggestions which may be implemented in Kerala. So for phase one, it is said not more than one new case in the district for the entire week should be there. The one condition satisfied. Second, no increase of more than 10% of the number of persons under home surveillance. So it's three conditions are there. One is on new cases, one on home surveillance, and there should be no hotspots. So if these three conditions satisfied, then phase one relaxations could be put into effect. What are the relaxations or how many restrictions would remain is given below. Phase two relaxation is further being stringent on these three aspects, new cases, home surveillance and number of people under home surveillance and infection. There should be no infection hotspots. Then phase three relaxation will be, so this is second review when phase two relaxations take place, and phase three relaxation when further review takes place. So further relaxation will be possible when more decline in cases are seen. So what are the relaxations or rather what are the restrictions during these three phases are shown here. So phase one restrictions would be stringent, like face mask compulsory, ban on those above 60 with history of comorbidity from stepping out, identity card must for travel purposes, odd even scheme for private vehicles, total clampdown on vehicle movement on Sunday, no flights, train services, government offices may open, and one person per house can go outside for 3 hours. So such conditions, no gathering of more than 5 persons, no religious congregations, attendance to marriage funerals to be 10. Even supermarkets, malls, cinemas, bars will remain closed. Phase two conditions are now, you can see, a little more eased, like auto taxis may be allowed, bus travel to short distance may be allowed. You know, people may be permitted to walk for 30 minutes before 7:30 a.m. MGNREGS, micro, small and medium enterprises can begin the activities. You know, workers at work site at 20 to 25% staff strength can work. So those are phase two relaxations. Phase three relaxations are further allowing domestic flights, inter-district bus transport. So such conditions, IT companies can open partially, hostels, residential facilities may be opened. Even universities, schools and colleges can open for exams in phase three. So this is the suggestion of Kerala committee, expert committee. So these were today's news, but then first important news, which will be important because every day new developments take place with respect to COVID-19. But an important news today is this: COVID-19 tests must be done for free. So this is the order of the Supreme Court. There was a petition filed in the Supreme Court that the private entities are conducting COVID-19 tests as they have been allowed by the government, and government has capped their price at ₹4,500. So this amount may not be affordable for a large section of the population. So petition was fined and Supreme Court has now ordered that tests related to COVID-19, whether done in approved government or private laboratories, shall be free of cost. So it has asked the government to issue the necessary directions immediately. So this is the order, you can see. So government laboratories are conducting tests for free, but private labs charge. But it says that this is not within the means of a large population of the country. The Supreme Court stated so. Then next is virus hits both genders equally, except in two nations. So it is seen in India and Pakistan that number of COVID-19 cases are more in men. So India, more than women, appear disproportionately likely to test positive for COVID-19, men more than women. So here you can see on April 6, 2020, Health Ministry said 76% of the confirmed cases in India were men. So experts say that this is possibly reflecting employment trend in India, because women are less likely to be traveling for work internationally too from India. So that is that. So here you can see percentage of female cases are shown. South Korea has 60% females affected by COVID-19. China is little below 50, while you can see India and Pakistan stand quite low. Then next is Afghan government releases 100 Taliban prisoners. So Afghan government has released 100 low-risk Taliban prisoners on 8 April 2020, a day after Taliban announced that they were walking out of talks with Kabul. So Taliban-US peace deal has taken place, and next step would be Taliban-Afghan government peace deal, and a precondition for that is release of prisoners by both Taliban and Afghan government. Taliban also has Afghanis in its custody. So this prisoner release has now been undertaken by Afghan government. Originally, it was supposed to take place on March 10, and post that there would be intra-Afghan peace talks, but now the release has later taken place on 8 April. And Afghan government was claiming that Taliban was asking top 15 commanders to be released, which it was reluctant to. And also Taliban said that Afghan government is needlessly wasting time. Finally, when it called for walking out of the talks, Afghan government released Taliban prisoners. So in Afghanistan, you should know that the Afghan government has control over a section of Afghan territory, but Taliban has huge sway over a large land in Afghanistan. So despite presence of US soldiers, and US also has opted out of Afghanistan, it wants to completely leave Afghanistan. So for its exit, it wants to have a deal finally with Taliban. So Taliban continues to attack Afghan government entities as such too. So now a peace deal is being sought. Then next is Mujibur Rahman's killer to face the gallows after 45 years. So Sheikh Mujibur Rahman, who was the founding father of Afghanistan, of Bangladesh, he was the first prime minister of the country too, and father of current prime minister of Bangladesh, Sheikh Hasina. He was killed along with most of his family members in a military coup which took place on 15th August 1975, nearly 4 years after he led Bangladesh to independence from Pakistan. Sheikh Hasina at that time was in Europe with her sister, so she survived the attack. And the attackers here as such were military commanders, you can see. So they were army officers. So Abdul Majid, he has been sentenced to death along with dozen other army officers for these murders in 1998, but he had fled the country, and now after 25 years, when he's returned, he has been sentenced to death and execution would take place. Bangladesh Supreme Court had also upheld the verdict in 2009. Five of the killers have already been executed. Now, Majid, who has returned to Bangladesh in March 2020, would also be executed. He had fled from Bangladesh to India in 1996. Then next is, rupee falls 70 paise as virus cases spike sharply. So the rupee declined 70 paise against the dollar on 8th April, following a sharp rise in the number of COVID-19 cases in the country. It closed at 75.83 a dollar, nearing its all-time low of 76.38 a dollar. For $1, you have to pay 76.38 rupees. So that is decline in rupees value. So presently it is at 75.83. All time low is 76.38. And the reasons for this are, of course, COVID-19 scenario, as well as rise in crude prices and strengthening of the dollar index. RBI also reduced the timing of market hours for call money market, government securities market, and currency market too. So this was to avoid undue volatility in the markets. The volumes are also less due to nationwide lockdown. And the last news is IRDAI permits insurers to grant 3 months moratorium on term loans. So in IRDAI, Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, has permitted insurers to grant a moratorium of 3 months on repayment of term loans sanctioned by them. So RBI has also given moratorium on term loans. So in the same context, in the COVID-19 scenario, IRDAI has also issued similar direction. However, as RBI had also stated, we have seen that interest shall continue to accrue on the outstanding portion of the term loans during such moratorium period. So you can have been given more time to repay, but interest will accumulate. So that is it. These are the important news items. Thank you.